العربية من الدين. Arabic is part of deen. It is the deen, right? And look, if someone wants to seek knowledge, and if someone wants to learn the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal, it is very important that he does something called ta'asil. What is ta'asil? Ta'asil, it is that you build a foundation that is solid. When that foundation is solid, you can build on it, right? What is the foundation that you must solidify? It is, number one, that you learn Arabic. By Arabic, we mean that, number one, the first step to learn Arabic is learning how to read and write it. Okay, that's the essential. Once you know how to read and write it, it is to go the next step and learning how to understand it and how to speak it and express yourself in Arabic. Okay, and obviously that comes with all the science of Arabic, learning grammar and morphology and learning rhetoric and going further and learning literature, etc. If one desires to do so. What is the objective of learning Arabic? The objective of learning Arabic is just to understand the Sharia, to understand the Deen, to understand the Quran, to understand the Sunnah of the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. And the ulama, a lot of them, or some of them, they consider it obligatory, because understand the Quran and Sunnah is obligatory. So they say whatever you require to get there, also becomes obligatory. طيب, we've understood that. Why is it important? One may ask, why is it important to know how to speak Arabic? Okay, it is important to know how to speak Arabic. Number one, a lot of people, what they do is they learn, and I'm a very severe critic when it comes to this. A lot of people, what they do is they learn grammar first, and they don't know how to speak the language. And you find a lot of people, they can perhaps understand Arabic and they know the grammar of Arabic, but when it comes to speaking, if you ask them a question, they'll say to you, listen, I know what you're saying, but I can't respond. Why is that a problem? Because knowing how to speak Arabic, it teaches you to understand the techniques of the Arabs and how they use their language. And that is very important when it comes to understanding the Quran. Because in the time of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, okay, a lot of non-Arabs were embracing Islam. And when they embraced Islam, they were obviously learning Arabic, but they were not know Arabic as well as the Arabs. The Arabs were eloquent, okay? So what happened? They started to interpret things from the Quran and understand things from the Quran, not in the way the Arabs understood it. And what that caused? It caused deviation. It caused deviation and misguidance. And that's where you find a lot of groups appeared that deviated from the truth. An example of that I'll give you, it is Allah Azza wa Jalla, he says in the Quran, there was people who appeared, the Mu'tazila. Okay, the Mu'tazila, they claim that the Quran, okay, that it is created. And we know that the Quran is not created. You say the Quran is created, it causes problems. Why? Because everything that's created, it has faults, right? It can have imperfections. And the Quran, it is not created, rather it's the speech of Allah, and it's an attribute of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Allah spoke it. Haqiqatan. طيب. So, what did they say that the Quran is created? They used evidence from the Quran. They said, Allah says in the Quran, Allahu khaliqu kulli shay. Allah created every shay, everything, right? Then they used to say, isn't the Quran shay? And then we say to them, yes, the Quran is shay. But you need to understand this ayah the way the Arabs understood it. The Arabs, they understood this ayah as Allah created everything that is created. Because if you say that everything that is called is shay, okay, is created, then you are in trouble. Because Allah says in the Quran, قُلْ أَيُّ شَيْءٍ أَكْبَرُ شَهَادَ قُلِ اللَّهِ. Say to Muhammad sallam, which shay, okay, أَكْبَرُ شَهَادَ, it's the greatest shahada. And then Allah says, قُلِ اللَّهِ. Say Allah. Allah describes himself as shay. So now if you say everything that is called shay is created, you're in trouble. So you have to understand the Quran the way the Arabs understood it. And that means that you learn how to speak their language the way they spoke it. And we're talking about the Arabs of the past, not the contemporary Arab, modern Arabic. And they use the Arabic language the way they used it and so on. That is very important. And the ulama of Nahu, of grammar, when they say the objective of Nahu, what it is, grammar, it is not to understand what it says in books or to be able to do i'rab or sentences. No, it is siyanatul lisan min al-lahan. It is to protect the tongue from making grammatical mistakes when you speak. The objective of it was speaking, because the Arabs were an oral society. It wasn't about reading and writing at the time. It's not about speaking. Now,
how can a person then start and learn in isolation?
In isolation, طيب, جميل. You start by, everyone's at a different level, right? It depends on what level you're at. First, you need to find or understand what level you're at. Once you understand what level you're at, start from what you're missing and you start with the basics. Okay, if one is going to start from reading, okay, start with that. مثلا القاعدة النورانية مثلا. Okay, you start by learning alphabets and learning and so on. And you can find lessons online, people teaching that, or you can any videos, etc. of that being taught and try to follow it. Or find someone to teach you it over FaceTime. Do not go to their house, stay at home. And what do you call it? That's one thing. The second thing, it is someone who knows how to read and write, but he wants to learn Arabic in terms of understanding it and speaking it. That person, I recommend him and I advise him to start by following a curriculum, whether it is Al-Arabiya Tubayniya, whether it is the Medina curriculum, and find perhaps someone to teach online, or find them, there's lessons online actually on YouTube that you can find these lessons being taught. And you can get the book online, PDF, okay? And then you can follow those lessons in terms of picking up vocabulary. And language, every language, it is learnt by listening. You need to immerse yourself in the language. You need to listen to the language a lot. You need to read a lot of Arabic, try to listen to a lot of Arabic. Everything that you learn, try to implement it and speak it. Because when you implement it and you use it in your speech and you write it and you try to structure sentences yourself, then that will help you remember things, because we tend to associate words with things and situations and so on. So it will help you remember vocabulary. Right? And the more you do it, don't be shy, try to practice someone, call someone that perhaps knows Arabic, FaceTime them, have a conversation with them, practice whatever you learned, and don't be afraid of making mistakes and let them laugh at you, but tomorrow you'll laugh at them as well, inshallah.